All right, so welcome to our test kitchen of measuring cups and measuring spoons with cookware junkies. As you can see, we've picked up over 20 different measuring cups and measuring spoons, pretty much everything that we could dig up on Amazon that was either a top seller, you know, top ranked, top reviewed, didn't look like they were out of business or going out of business soon, I guess. So we've got quite the selection here, whether it be measuring cups, measuring spoons, dry, liquid. We pretty much are covering them all. So we've spent the last 8 hours kind of going through all these, combing through each one, and never knew that there was so much to know about measuring cups and measuring spoons. Awesome. So out of all this stuff that we had a chance to review today, I guess what was one of the biggest, surprises out of what we've learned today?
Well, I think the biggest surprise was cost versus whether it was good or not. Some of the most expensive ones weren't quite as good as the less expensive ones.
I was expecting here to have the hour of small differences here where it seems like everything is basically the same. But there were actually pretty big distinctions between some of these, especially in the spoons.
Mm-hmm. We definitely went through and found a lot of differences between, you know, even from the higher end to the medium, lower end kind of price point spoons. And yeah, so like what did we find as it relates to price point? And you had mentioned, you know, that some of the cups and the spoons that we saw priced higher, you know, there was some that performed fairly well for a medium price point.
Sure. Our number one, not to spoil it, in the dry measuring cups is the OXO plastic cups. At $8 is one of the cheapest sets in the batch, but we gave it top marks for everything. It was extremely accurate, it was easy to use, and the build quality was high.
Yeah, so that's the one we're looking at here, is this one?
Yep.
Okay, yeah, this one actually was kind of neat. It had not only the hanging thing, it had the nice leveler, right?
And it's got the snap hooks to hold it all together, so you don't have to lose a ring and then find it again.
Right, and not to mention, like, how often do we just take these cups, throw them in the drawer, and they're just kind of sitting by themselves without a ring?
Most people use the ring. They like to have the ring with their cups to keep them together. But if you don't want to use your ring, or if you're messy, some people might be, you have no excuse, and you can just clip them together like that. So that was the only measuring cup or spoon that had a quality like that. I thought was pretty convenient.
Yeah, and so extra coming in at $8?
At $8.
Right. So that was probably one of our biggest surprises, because we're looking at measuring cups and measuring spoons. We had some that were priced at, like, what were?
Yeah, our most expensive one was the Norpo metal ones at $32. Mm-hmm. We were really expecting a lot from them, and they wound up at the bottom of the pile. They had an interesting shape, which was good for scooping into canisters, but their biggest problem was the handle.
Yeah, that was these ones here.
Yeah, they've got this rubber handle cover here that is going to be absolutely impossible to clean under, and sooner or later you're going to wind up infecting everybody you cook for when you can't clean out under that handle.
Yeah, all sides just came up completely, just ready to grow bacteria uncontrollably and get the whole house sick, or Christmas time and those cookies that you make, you're going to get all your friends and relatives sick.
Yeah, which is a shame too, because the quality and the design seemed right on the mark. It even had the little notches inside here for measuring, you know. If you happen to lose the other ones, you have one, you can still make it work, but yeah, that's too bad.
Yeah, we were expecting a lot from them and it just didn't deliver.
Yeah, so I mean, like, really what makes an ideal, and what you would say, what makes the difference between a bad measuring cup or a bad, you know, measuring spoon versus a good one?
Well, as far as functionality, what I came across when I was using all of them is the comfort level. A lot of these just had very sharp edges. Some of them you can kind of see the metal was very thin and just hurt you when you were measuring.
Yeah, to measure that, we got some brown sugar and we intentionally staled it, I assure you, so that it was chunky and hard to get, so we had to really dig in there. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. We used that to test how it felt to really handle these spoons and how strong they were. Some of our plastic ones just didn't hold up to the challenge. Another thing we were looking for was accuracy. How do you measure a measuring spoon? The answer turns out to be very carefully. We got a very precisely calibrated scale and spent a long time with an irrigation syringe carefully filling it up to the absolute max and then measuring how much it took. They're actually generally pretty accurate. We've got our best are pretty much bang on. The plastic OXO here was pretty much exactly right, and the Cuispro spoons, second one, were pretty much exact. On the bad side, we have the New Star.
So right here.
The New Star dry measuring cups were off by 7.5%. That's enough to completely throw off a recipe.
Oh man, those were the ones with the amazing handles.
Love the handles.
Yeah, those were great. Those were the only ones that had like a really unique design to them. And
very comfortable handle. You can manipulate them however you need to with absolutely zero pain as opposed to some of the other ones.
Right, and we even thought because they look like they might just be, instead of like a nice weld soldered on, that it would be really flimsy and easy to break off, but we gave it our best shot, mm-hmm. and it did hold on pretty well.
If only they actually measured. Unfortunately, right. if only you could actually read the marks on them.
Exactly.
You flip these over, they're only marked on the very bottom, and in 8 hours, they were all. It seems like the marks were starting to rub off just a little bit.
Yeah, so I think that does really define what makes a good and a bad, you know, measuring cup or spoon, as the accuracy for one. But, you know, the design, that's too bad.
Yeah. Oh, you managed to snap a couple of these, right?
Yeah, and the KitchenAid ended up not really standing up, but at its $4 price point, I don't know that we expected the plastic one to hold up to much punishment, but for $4, the KitchenAid isn't a bad deal here. It was accurate, right?
Yeah. The KitchenAid was reasonably accurate.
Okay.
And for $4, well, if you're not intentionally trying to break it, maybe you won't.
Sure. And I think there's a lot of situations where you might want a cheap set of measuring spoons.
Yeah, you should get one of those for camping.
Oh yeah, that would be an ideal way to go for $4. Yeah.
Or for the baby to play with.
Sure.
Yeah, we do need something. Plus, they're going to be nice and quiet, banged against the pot.
Now, speaking of which, I think while we were testing earlier, you mentioned that one of these, I think it was this set, would be good also for maybe that situation where it was a solid design, you know, solid accuracy, but, you know, maybe something that for the price point, I think it came with the spoons and the cups.
Oh, yeah. The Prep Works by Progressive here is a set. It was
$8.
$8 gets the measuring cups and the spoons. Oh. It's an extremely large set, probably unreasonably large. It includes all kinds of things that you will never use. Yeah.
For $8, maybe you send this away with somebody who's getting their first apartment.
Sure.
And just needs to fill the kitchen cabinets with something.
Right.
It didn't have the best measurements, but they were easy to use, and there were a lot of them. And it's $8, and you're set.
Mm-hmm. So out of all these cups and spoons, were there any that actually didn't work or didn't perform? I mean, you'd expect them all to pretty much be able to do their job, right?
Yeah, but not so much for the chef craft. Can't argue with the value at $4.50 for the cups and the spoons.
Oh, right. And they had awesome markings.
Yeah, so they had really good markings.
Excuse me.
But... they pretty much bent double most of the time.
Yeah.
Now they didn't break, but
impossible.
I would not want to try to measure anything with these and hope it actually came out.
Right. It was impossible to scoop brown sugar. It did not.
It was almost impossible to scoop flour.
We did try to snap them, but they're just too bendy.
Yeah. So like when you're thinking about the metal ones, you kind of pretty much assume across the board. That your metal ones are going to be more durable, but we found earlier that one or two of these at least did not stand up.
Yeah, some of the metal ones were pretty thin.
The New Star here Yeah, Shelly, you used the New Star one to scoop out and everything, and you were testing that one out for...
I did. right away, I could feel the sharp edges on these, which made me very uncomfortable, a little nervous to even use it. Going into the flour wasn't too bad because you're not putting pressure, but once I went into the brown sugar, I started getting marks on my hands. Mm. It was just a little painful, honestly. So if you are cooking all day or just making a lot of batches of one certain thing, your hands are going to get pretty sore from these, that's for sure. Mm.
Yeah. And the Prepworks metal had the really interesting magnets that we really liked.
Oh my goodness.
We gave it a little bit of a bend and it got a little bit worse. It's the magnets give it a little bit of a bend and it bends real easy, and then the magnet starts to separate from the metal, and I can see bad things happening with that set after a few runs through the dishwasher.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so cool concept, but you might have to be careful and baby them a little
bit. Yeah, you're gonna have to baby those.
Yeah, it's too bad because the double sided.
Really cool.
And yeah, I mean, like, how awesome is that just to throw that in your drawer and they're always together?
Yeah.
I mean, I'm always searching through my drawer for random objects. Like, I can't imagine throwing, you know, let's say 8 of these in my drawer without a spoon and then without a ring and trying to have to search for them.
Yeah. Oh yeah, because we've got different shapes here on the spoons. You have the classic round ones, like always had as a kid.
Sure.
But then we've also got these interesting ones that are rectangle or oval. With the idea that you're going to be able to fit those into a spice jar.
Mm-hmm.
Even the tablespoon can get into probably a, you know, pretty narrow jar.
Yeah.
So the magnetic ones there give you best of both worlds. You got the round end and the oblong end.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's too bad that I'm worried that they're just not going to hold up.
Hmm. Well, let's talk a little bit about the wet and the dry cups over there. You already told us a little different, or what the difference is between those wet and dry ones, but how did they handle when, you know, like just pouring, you know, filling them up and measuring all that?
After we tested the accuracy on them, we just tried to fill them up, measure them a little bit, and see what it was like to use them. Mm-hmm. We've got the Anchor Hawking here. This one was probably our favorite. It was easy to use, easy to read, it's accurate. It's got one odd thing though. It's got metric measurements on one side and imperial on the other, but the way it's laid out, if you hold the cup with your right hand, you're looking at the metric measurements. Mm. So this one expects you to hold the cup with your left hand, or you'd be using metric, which I don't really do much, so that's, except for that, it's almost perfect.
And that one came in at $10?
Yeah, for $10.
Okay. And then, so now, is that the one with the short handle that was really super awkward and weird?
No, I think that was the Pyrex that was giving you trouble here.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Because that's got that short handle, plus a weird shape.
Yeah, so this one was the same $10, right?
Yeah.
Yep, $10.
And then it seems like since it's bigger and it's going to have more weight in there, if let's say you're maybe elderly or, you know, like you have small hands.
Even
or...
for me, I felt like it was just too heavy for such a small, item here. I was uncomfortable. Once we put water in it, it felt heavy, and I just thought it was a little strange how
short the handle was.
Plus, it takes up more space in your cabinet because it's wider.
And the surprise on that was that the pour spout is really not that good. It didn't want to pour especially well.
No.
Now, the surprise was the Rubbermaid gear, which was very inaccurate. It was off by about 10%. It doesn't look great. But it turns out this actually pours better than the Pyrex here, though it has no pour spout.
Wow.
Which is thought. Just bizarre.
Right.
Now, the interesting one is the OXO here, which has this special inside measuring ring.
Mm-hmm.
So you can measure it either looking at it straight side on or straight down from the top.
Was it the same looking at it straight on as it was looking at it sideways?
It's really, really close. Mm. I measured it like 3 milliliters different.
Wow.
Okay. So the only thing, like, what about cleaning this? Because you have so many angles in there?
Yeah.
How did that work out?
I'm a little worried about that if you were measuring, like, molasses or something sticky, that there's going to be,
like
8 different weird angles that you got to get, batter.
Like you forgot about it, left it, you know, after breakfast, and...
Yeah. So if you want that, if you like that cup, you got to be attentive. But it's really good, and it's $8.
And it's
$8?
Microwave safe, which I'm surprised with this rubber handle.
I think if you mess that up too bad, you maybe just accidentally throw it away and buy a new one. decide how much $8 of your labor is worth.
Speaking of design, like, were there any of these that had like an amazing design that stood up for, you know, like, let's say if somebody wanted a nice set to like give as a gift or to, you know, like, you know, just kind of have something sitting out, any of those?
To answer the opposite of your question, I would really not like to have the prep works sitting out. These are really hideously ugly.
Thank you, I didn't want to say that.
Well, I figured I had to.
Do these come in different colors?
Probably not.
No.
Oh, okay, so.
I checked. All right. I did like them. I thought they were good.
Because they are probably one of our best values. Maybe if you're, you know, a school teacher or something and you want to have, like, you know, something in the classroom for whatever the kids to play around, kindergarten teacher or something, you know, you can have plenty of cups for the money that you spend.
Home economics class, so it'd be fine.
Yeah, this was the one. Right, these ones were very nice as far as aesthetics go. And they were solid build too. This is the OXO Good Grips, and with the magnets that attach there, and everything looked pretty sealed on there, so.
Well, what wasn't good about this one, I don't know if you were able to notice as you were gripping them, the edges here are a little sharp, and if you look in the back here, it was gonna be very hard to clean.
Oh, yeah.
It's got that little pocket. Yeah.
And one other thing we noticed, the measurements are painted on, versus engraved.
Oh yeah, that was the one we took a little scrubby pad worked on one for a minute and it was noticeably worse. Yeah.
So while they have great design, maybe
not designed for the ages.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so and then what was the price point? $20?
$20.
Okay, so $20. Yeah. Okay.
Won't last very long.
Out of all of these, I guess let's talk about which one, maybe if, let's say, money wasn't an object and you didn't care and you were spending somebody else's money for spoons and measuring cups. What do you think as far as, let's talk about the cups. Measuring cup wise, you know, price isn't an object here.
You know, it's hard to argue with those OXO plastic ones. Mm-hmm. If I was going to go with a different one, it would be the Simply Gourmet. This is a good set with a lot of cups. It generally feels pretty good. It's quite accurate. But they're a little more awkward to handle. You've got the short handle, which is good if you're trying to get it into a jar or something. But it's not quite as comfortable.
And this one has the marks all inside and the outside and everything, right?
Yeah, this one has secondary marks that you can see from the inside.
I like that.
So if you want to try to, you know, layer some stuff up.
Right.
Mm-hmm. Plus, it's nice and compact, and I do like the design. $24. I don't think it's three times as good as those OXOs. Mm-hmm. But
yeah.
I like
it. So again, if we're not talking price, that might be. And then what about like for the spoons? Like, let's say same question for the spoons. Just, you know, overall best spoon that we have on the table.
Overall best one. Is the Quizzy Pro.
Okay.
Those
were only $15.
Yeah, ones were not sharp, easy, comfortable to hold. And the best part about these ones was the slender shape. You were able to dip right into any container you needed, really.
Yeah, nice little finish on them. Mm-hmm. Sure.
Yeah, and the measurements were embossed here very well. So that's going to last quite a while.
All right, so $15 on those. And so I guess overall on the measuring cups, we kind of touched on those for the most part. I mean, $8 to $10 is pretty much where they sat.
Yep.
So you pretty much know what you're getting there. And then I guess overall, like, where is the value to be had here? Like, really, where would I, you know, like, want to put my chips? We talked about the OXO here being a very good pick overall. Would that be your, you know, value pick if you had to make one?
Oh yeah, the OXO is my value. The OXO plastic dry measuring cups are my value pick.
Mm-hmm.
They're one of the cheapest on the board for the dry cups, and they were the best in our test.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So like in comparison to, let's say, the Norpro plastic ones were $1 cheaper. While they were nice, they were nothing compared to what you would get for the other dollar, right?
Yeah. Well, if you don't care about the ring that's holding them together.
Oh, that's right.
That caused us a bit of a problem. Mm-hmm. Otherwise, they were reasonably good.
This is not a ring. This is a weird triangular
puzzle.
Clothes hook that you have to take each
off. Yeah, it's a blacksmith's puzzle.
Because
yes.
You can't get them off this end. You have to go through every other
end. Yeah, now that's the one you had to put back in alphabetical order.
Yes.
Right?
Yes.
Right.
So.
Okay. Yeah. They were all right, but the OXOs are much more than a dollar better.
Mm-hmm. Mm. Yeah, the OXO even has the leveler attached. That helps hang them up. If you don't want to throw them in the drawer, you can just hang them up.
Awesome.
Yeah.
And what about the spoons? Out of the spoons, where, you know, is the value to be had here in buying a set? Or is there a specific, just, you know, standalone set of spoons that you might want to buy without the cups?
No, I didn't think there was that much value in any of the sets, except for maybe the progressive for, you know, a specific situation. The new star wasn't quite good enough, and the chef's craft definitely wasn't good enough. If I was going to be looking for value on the spoons, maybe this, you know, all the prices are about the same. You're going to spend probably between about $10 and $15 on any of these sets of metal spoons. Mm. The Quizzipro at $15, you could call your best value, but you might also go with the Spring Chef at $12. It's a little cheaper and it's really just about as good. They also have that interesting rectangular shape. That can be really good too, especially if you're trying to get into jars a lot. Mm-hmm. That could be just a little bit better and a little bit cheaper. Otherwise, I'd say spend the extra money. It's $3.
Okay. Yeah. And then there was like a set that was basically free, if you paid shipping kind of thing, right? It was the Chef Craft that came in at $4.50 and they ended up giving you like 30 pieces.
Yeah. So, but these are the ones that bent basically in half and you weren't able to get anything.
Sure, but for somebody looking just to buy them for whatever, you know, that they might not necessarily even intend on keeping them for $4.50, mm-hmm. I mean...
Yeah, $4.50, sure, I mean, why not?
Yeah.
But I'd say go the $8 and get the progressive set.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
That's cups and spoons, and if you lose half of them, you still have more than everybody else.
Right, if we're just talking about them being hideous across the board, right? They're both equally hideous in a way with the green big lettering.
Yeah, yeah.
I mean, so I guess either way on that one, right?
Yeah. Spend the money on good measuring spoons. Don't worry too much about the dry measuring cups. You can get by with a reasonably priced offering for the liquid measuring cups. Pick your favorite style. Do you like the glass or the plastic? Either way, you get a good value.
All right, well, thanks for joining us on cookwarejunkies.com for our measuring spoons and measuring cup review. I hope you found this helpful, and now you know exactly which one out of these 30,000 measuring cups and spoons that you could look at purchasing based on your specific need. And I'd like to say budget, but they're pretty much all around the same ballpark. I mean, obviously, don't go out and spend $32 or $35 on the Norpo, because that was probably our biggest surprise overall. The most expensive set here on the table is probably gave us the biggest letdown.
Yep. All right, and if you live in our area, maybe you can get some free ones, because we're going to be hucking them out of the car windows as we drive around.
We're testing durability, of course.